Hey there everybody, DestroyerX here, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play called Let's Play Super Mario Bros. 2 for the Nintendo Entertainment System. Story. When Mario opened a door after climbing a long stair in his dream, another world spread before him and he heard a voice call for help to be freed from a spell. After awakening, Mario went to a cave nearby, and to his surprise, he saw exactly what he saw in his dream. Press start button. Push start button. We have four characters. We have Mario, Luigi, Toad, and Princess Toadstool. And let's get into the game. First of all, the game was released. Super Mario Bros. 2 was released in North America on October 9th, 1988. It was released in Europe on April 28th, 1989. It was released in Australia sometime in May of 1989. It was released in Japan on September 14th, 1992. Super Mario Bros. 2 is a modified port of the Famicom Disk System game called Yume Kōjō, Doki Doki Panic. So yeah, there we go. The reason why we got the modified port is because the original Super Mario Bros. 2 Nintendo of America thought it was too hard and too similar to Super Mario Bros. So that's why we have this. But yeah, basically here is the premise of the game. One day, Mario had a dream about the subcom fairies. They basically said that Wart has captured them and taken over control of subcom, which is the land of dreams. And Mario has to go and save the subcom fairies. Now the next day, Mario is having a picnic with Luigi, Toad, and Princess Toadstool, also known as Princess Peach. And to his surprise, he sees a cave with the same stairway that he saw in his dream. And he went into the stairwell and, well, fell right into subcom. So there you go. Since it is a port of a Famicom Disk System game, of course there are going to be some mechanics in which are not Mario-like. But I'll get into that here in a moment. We're going to go into some stats of the characters. For example, let's go into Mario's stats. Mario is the Prince of Average. He has the second best speed in the entire game. He has the second best jump in the entire game. And he has the second best power rating in the entire game, which basically means he can pick up items pretty quickly. Luigi, he has slightly lower speed than Mario and slightly less power as far as, you know, picking up items. But he also has a sophisticated jump. He has a flutter jump, which is a lot better than Mario's jump. Toad, he has the best speed in the game. He has the best power rating, which means he can pick up items very fast. But to compensate for that, he is incredibly... well, he just sucks at jumping. And Princess Peach, she has the worst speed in the game, and she has the worst power rating in the game. However, she has the third highest jump in the game, but she also has a floating jump, which you can use whenever you basically jump with her. If you hold down the A button, she'll use her dress as a kind of a parachute to pretty much slow her descent. And we have some items in this game that, you know, some of them are pretty much Mario-based and others are not. You got a mushroom, but actually I'll show you right here. Currently right now, Luigi has 2 units of health. And he can actually expand the units of health to 4 units of health. How do you do that? Well, if you grab a magic potion out of a tuft of grass, like so, there we go. You throw it in a certain spot, you can access subspace. And depending upon if you're in the correct spot, you can actually find a mushroom. If you grab the mushroom, you increase your health meter until you have 4. I mean, you'll increase it to 3, and then eventually you increase it to 4. So there you go. If you get down to 1 unit of health, you're small Mario, small Luigi, small Toad, small Peach. Until you either grab a heart or you grab another mushroom to increase your health meter. Over here, of course, you'll notice coins in subspace that I'm grabbing from the ground. I'll get into that here in just a little bit. But we'll go ahead and go into some other things. Actually, coins are used for the slot machine currency. So that's basically, if you have coins, you can play the slot machine at the end of each level. So there you go. That's basically it. Hearts, you can actually get hearts by defeating 8 enemies in a row. A small heart will appear, and will, of course, if you grab the heart, it will restore 1 unit of health. And if you're small, you'll be back to normal. That's all there is to it. Let's see, 1 mushroom, you get an extra life. Cherries, you grab 5 cherries, you get a Starman. Well, a Starman will appear. If you grab the Starman, you're invincible for a small period of time. You have POW blocks, which if you grab a POW block and throw it, you can defeat the vast majority of enemies on the screen just simultaneously. About the only thing you are not able to defeat are Trouters, which, well, you'll see Trouters later on, and you'll understand why you cannot defeat them. Let's see. There's some other items that you'll find. You'll find turtle shells inside tufts of grass, which if you grab a turtle shell, you can throw it. It'll skid across the ground and damage enemies as it goes until it runs into a wall. And once it runs into a wall, it disappears. However, you can actually ride on a turtle shell if you're careful enough. Let's see, mushroom blocks. By the way, those are Trouters. They're jumping up and down from the waterfalls. That's why you can't defeat them with a POW block. Mushroom blocks. If you find those, then you can use them as platforms, or you can use them to defeat enemies. And of course, you have vegetables, which there are 2 different types. There are the unripe vegetables, which are smaller, and there are the ripe vegetables, which are larger. If you grab 5 ripened vegetables, you will actually pull a stopwatch. The stopwatch itself, basically you can use it to freeze all the enemies on the screen for a few seconds. And beyond that, as you saw in World 1-2, there was a magic carpet that was being ridden on by a Pidget. If you defeat the Pidget, you can take the magic carpet for yourself and you can ride it until it disappears. So now we're going to talk about the slot machine mechanic. This slot machine mechanic, as I mentioned before, if you have coins, you can play the slot machine. If you get 3 vegetables, you get a 1-up. Get 3 Sniffits, you get a 1-up. You get 3 Starmen, you get a 1-up. If you get a cherry in the first slot, you get a 1-up. You get cherry in the first 2 slots, you get a 2-up. And if you get 3 cherries, you get a 5-up. So that is awesome. Some of the characters in Super Mario Bros. 2 you'll actually see in later games. Of course, I forgot to mention, in Japan they call this Super Mario USA. Isn't that awesome? But anyway, some of the enemies you see in this game you'll see in later games. Which I'll get into here in a second. That thing that's chasing me is a Fanto. Fanto chases me whenever I pick up the key. He'll continue to chase me until I drop the key or I make my way to the locked door and open it by pressing the up button to open a door. There you go. But yeah, as I mentioned before, some of the characters in the game, you can actually find them in later games. Some of the characters being Bezos, those actually are the Shioways in Super Mario RPG Legend of the Seven Stars. But Bombs, they're probably the most popular character in the game. You have the Ninji, you can find those in in Super Mario World. And we'll go into more characters here in a little bit. But now we're facing off against the World 1 boss. And the World 1 boss, it is Mauser! Mauser is a common character that was in the Super Mario Bros. Super Show, so yay. Mauser's goal in life is to chuck bombs at you, and the way to defeat him is he has to be caught in a bomb blast 3 times. The bomb blast can hurt you, so be careful, because it can hurt you. But yeah, he gets caught in bomb blast 3 times, he's done. Ouch, I got hit in a bomb blast! Ouch. But yeah, going into the characters again, Pokey, he is actually seen in later games, with exception of the Super Mario All-Stars version of the game. He is yellow instead of green. Pidgets you'll see in Super Mario World as Pidget Bills. You have Shy Guys, they're some of the most common enemies you see in later games. Sniffits, same thing. And definitely Birdos. Birdos are definitely popular. Which I'll get into Birdos later. Because I kind of didn't talk about them. But I'll talk about them in a little bit. This is going to be a no-warping run. If you want to know where the warp zones are at, you can look on, well, Mario Wiki or, somewhere. You can go on a Mario Wiki. Or you can go on YouTube. You'll find them. Or go on Game FAQs. But yeah. That's pretty much about it. Let's see. What else? But yeah, no warping run. I'm going to be using all the characters. Basically because I'm going to give them a turn at each level. At each world, I should say. So, that way they're all being played equally. Normally when I do play, I tend to play with Peach only, but I decided, you know what, let's go ahead and do this with all of the characters. So, yeah. To dig, all you have to do is just basically press the B button to dig. That's all you have to do. But I'm gonna go into the bosses. At the end of each world, generally at the end of each world, you'll usually run into a Birdo. Birdo will shoot eggs, will spit eggs at you. All you have to do is basically grab the egg, and you can spit it back. You can throw it right back at Birdo. Three hits, Birdo's down, you grab the crystal ball, the hawk mouth opens, and you go to the slot machine. And that's pretty much all there is to it. So yeah, that's basically it. Isn't that awesome? Different color enemies, depending upon if they have a different color palette or not, they'll actually have different attributes. For example, almost forgot, Desert Stage. Desert Stages, like the you'll see Cobrats. Cobrats, they actually shoot, bullets at you. Sniffits also shoot bullets at you as well. So, yay! I'm trying to cover as much as I can. There's a lot to cover in this game. But yeah, I'm trying to think. But yeah, you'll see like red and pink Shy Guys. Red ones, they'll actually move in a straight line until they find an obstacle in which they can use to turn around. Pink Shy Guys, they'll actually turn around as soon as they get to the end of a platform. Let's see, Sniffits, there are four different colors of Sniffits. Red Sniffits, they can walk off ledges, they'll just walk in a straight line. Pink Sniffits, they'll move back and forth on a platform. And gray and green Sniffits, they'll jump and shoot their bullets at you. And of course you have the Bezos. There are how many colors of Bezos? Bezos. Red, gray, and green. Red, they'll dive bomb you, and green and gray, they will actually fly in a straight line. There is that's Pokey. You can actually jump on Pokey's head and you can defeat it by just picking up its head and throwing it a few times. So, yeah. Or you can try and knock it. You can try and defeat it by using either some kind of an item or using an enemy to actually, well, defeat the Pokey. Yeah, I'm being so descriptive. It's just amazing, isn't it? Yeah, it is, isn't it? But yeah, a lot of the Super Mario Bros. 2 enemies, they actually appear in the Super Mario Bros. Super Show because, Super Mario Bros. Didn't really have a whole lot of enemies, so they went ahead and just used the Super Mario Bros. 2 enemies in that cartoon, except they just excluded Wart, so there you go. But yeah, Wart has not been seen in a Mario game since Super Mario Bros. 2. And now we get into the Red Birdo. Red Birdo, they shoot out three projectiles at a time. And of course, they will shoot out eggs, and they also shoot out fireballs at random. But they're defeated the same way. You can use the mushroom blocks that are down there to defeat it, or you can just throw the eggs back at Birdo. That's pretty much it. I mean, it's not that hard at all. Oh my. I'm trying to think of something else. I can't think of anything else right now. I'm just kind of going along. This game was remade whenever it was ported to the Super NES in Super Mario All-Stars, so, yeah. Which was a graphical enhancement. I may play it one day, I don't know. Typically, it's one of those things where if I feel like it, I may play it, I may not. I just don't know. But oh well, doesn't matter. Oh my, let's see. So far, so good. We're moving right along. You know, I've actually done quite a few test playthroughs of this game, and for some reason or another, I kept botching the test playthroughs, because the thing is that, you can't, if you run out of lives, then it's game over, obviously. But you are given the option to have continues. And I think there's two continues before you go way, way back to the beginning. But if you use a continue, then you are sent back to the first level of the world in which you died in. So let's say I died in 2-3. If I lost all my lives in 2-3, I use a continue, I would go all the way back to 2-1. If I lose all of my lives, all of my continues, I will go back to world 1-1. And there you go. Yay. Isn't that awesome? But yeah, let's see. I can tell you right now, as far as the levels go, world 1 is grass, world 2, desert, world 3, waterfall, caves, world 4, ice and snow, world 5 is a night level, world 6 is a desert level, and world 7 is a sky level. I spoiled it for you, didn't I? I spoiled it! Let's see. In the original Doki Doki Panic, there was a, actually, I'll talk about that whenever I get to it. I'm not gonna talk about it right now. I'm not gonna spoil everything. So, we'll talk about it later. But yeah, most of the music in Doki Doki Panic, it wasn't changed. Some of the music was changed to fit the Mario theme. Like, for example, let's see, some of the music had an Arabian theme to it, and it was changed to Mario Brothers appropriate music. Like, for example, when you become invincible, it originally had some kind of Arabian music going, and that was changed to the Starman theme from a remix of the Starman theme. When you enter subspace, it was another Arabian theme music, but it got changed to, a remix of the original Super Mario Brothers theme. So, yeah. Other than that, that's pretty much about it. Most of the music itself, some music essentially was the same, but since the NES does not have an FM synthesis chip, nor does it have the Famicom disk system attachment to it, obviously we don't get the enhanced audio, but it is okay. Whenever they ported it over, they pretty much took into account that the NES in some aspects was inferior, so they dealt with it accordingly. But honestly, you should actually listen to some games that were made with the Famicom, and then listen to the games that were ported to the NES. But anyway, back to the game. Now we're facing off against Triclide. Triclide is a three-headed snake that spits fireballs at you. So how do you defeat a three-headed snake? You just throw the mushroom blocks at it. That's all you have to do. Simple, isn't it? But yeah, one of the things I like to do, I mean, it doesn't really help out that much in this level, but one of the things I really like doing is kind of making like a small protective barrier with the mushroom blocks, because, as you can see, the mushroom blocks will actually, each time the fireballs hit the mushroom blocks, they kind of bounce off of it and dissipate. So I kind of like making a fort with it. It may not be a practical way to defeat Triclide, but it works for me. It may work for you as well. So We'll go with that. As you can see, Tri-Cly can't spit too high up, so I'm pretty good. So all you have to do is chuck 3 mushroom blocks at Tri-Cly, or you can use a tweeter if you're daring. And I messed up. Ow. That's great. And there goes Tri-Clyde. And there goes the tweeter. There's the door. We're done with the level, aren't we? Yes, we are. But yeah, we're also almost done with part 1. So what will happen is in part 2, we're going to continue the game a little bit more and see what wackiness we get ourselves into for part 2. But yeah, that's it. All right, everybody, take care and ciao for now.